Hello and welcome to StudyIQ. In this lecture, let us discuss about the rail safety in India. We have recently seen a rail accident, and this is not a single incident in India. We all know. So it is very important to know what are the reasons for this accidents or what are the drawbacks in the rail safety in our country. What are the government initiatives in order to tackle this problem? And let us also discuss about a committee which was appointed to look upon the rail safety in India. So let us start. Before we move on to the core of this topic, we must understand what is the relevance of Indian railways or what is the relevance of the rail network in India. So relevance. Indian Railways is the largest employer in the country, employing about 1.3 million people. So, largest employer in the country and it employs around 1.3 million. It is also among the top 10 employers in the world. So, Indian Railways is one among the top 10 employers in the world. It is also the third largest rail network in the world by its size. Also, it handles the largest number of passengers in the world. It is around 8,300 million passengers annually. And with these data, we can understand what is the significance and relevance of Indian railways in India. Coming to our topic, that is the rail safety. What has happened in the recent times with the rail safety? Let us quickly have a look at what has happened in the recent history of Indian Railways. During 2012 to 2018, till now, around 600 rail accidents has taken place in the country. The 600 is a very big number if we take the case of rail accidents. You must understand that each train would carry a lot number of passengers. And around 600 accidents in this 5 or 6 years is a very big number, and this is a cause of concern for the country. Here you must note down that the total serious train accidents has declined, but the total number of derailments has gone up. So here total serious accidents came down, but derailments has gone up. Around 85% of the total train accidents are due to derailments. 85% of total train accidents are because of derailments. The Kakodar committee, which was appointed in the year 2012. This committee is regarding the rail safety. The recommendations of this committee will be discussed later in this module itself. In this lecture itself, we will discuss about the recommendations. But here, the Kakodar committee has said that only 15% of the total derailments are due to sabotage. And the committee said that the rest, that means the other 85% of the total derailments are due to factors which are completely under the control of railway administration. So 85% is due to factors which could have been controlled or which could have been managed by the railway administration. In another report, Niti Aayog says that around 90% of the total rail accidents in the country are due to either derailments or level crossings. So, according to Niti Aayog, 90% of total rail accidents in the country either due to derailment or due to level crossing. Niti Aayog also says that human failures have accounted for around 87% of the rail accidents in India. So, 87% of rail accidents is caused by human error. This can be either the railway staff or the road users. So, this human error can be either caused by railway staff or road users. The rest of the rail accidents, that is the 90% according to the Niti Aayog, is either due to derailment or level crossing. And the Niti Aayog says that the rest of the accidents can be due to failure of equipment, sabotage or incidental factors. This increasing number of rail accidents in India does not only cause human loss and infrastructural damage. Other than infrastructural damage and human loss, it also creates a fiscal strain. to the already financially strained or stressed organization, that is the Indian Railway. So Indian Railway is already financially stressed, and adding upon that, this damages or the rail accidents causes financial strain to the Indian Railways in terms of compensation provided to the victims. So the first loss is human loss, second one infrastructural damage, the third one financial strain on Indian Railways in the form of compensation to the victims. Now let us analyze what are the causes of rail accidents in India. Causes. The first one is the consequential rail accidents. This include collisions, derailments, level crossing, train fires, similar accidents, etc. Example, level crossing, derailment, fires, collisions, etc. The second one is derailments. Second one, derailments. Out of the total consequential accidents, around 50% is caused by derailments. Derailments happen because of wear and tear of the track, failure of components like wheels, or because of human error. It can be either due to human error, wear and tear, failure of components, etc. Another cause is the level crossing accidents. Level crossing accidents. This can be either manned level crossing or unmanned level crossing. Around 40% of the consequential accidents are caused due to level crossing. Next reason is the lack of maintenance. The total track length of the Indian Railways is more than 1 lakh. Track length is more than 1 lakh. And out of this total length, around 4,500 kilometers should be renewed every year. Annual renewance is needed for at least 4,500 kilometers. But due to the financial constraints of the Indian Railways, not more than half is renewed every year. So financial constraints of Indian Railways does not allow it to renew more than half of this total length, which should be renewed annually. Another cause is the unfilled vacancies in Indian Railways. Unfilled vacancies. There is a persistent shortage of loco pilots. Around 20% of the total vacancies of the loco pilots is vacant. As a result of this vacancy, the available loco pilots are allotted overtime work. So, this has led to overtime work for the already existing loco pilots. And due to this overwork, there are chances of error. Similar to the case of loco pilots, there is also a 16% vacancy in safety staff. So, safety staff is also in short in the Indian Railways. This also leads to overwork, overtime work of the available staff, and this has caused human errors in the railway network. Another reason is the financial mismanagement. Financial mismanagement. The track upkeep and renewal is carried out by the depreciation reserve fund. Carried out by depreciation reserve fund of the railways. What we have seen here is that the Indian government, instead of increasing this fund, we see a decreasing tendency in the fund. So decreasing depreciation reserve fund in the budget. We don't have a railway budget now. It's a union budget. So decreasing depreciation reserve fund in the budget has led to financial mismanagement of the Indian Railways. Another reason is the procedural lapse. Procedural lapse. No observance of the mandatory operating procedure has led to many rail accidents. So non-observance of mandatory operating procedure. Also, at times, no speed restriction warnings are put. And according to the 15th Parliamentary Standing Committee on Railways, more than 50% of the total rail accidents are more than 50% of the total rail accidents in India are due to the lapses in part of the railway staff. Another cause of concern is the slow expansion of the Indian Railways. The Parliamentary Committee on Railways has noted that the slow expansion in the railways has put burden on the existing infrastructure, which has led to severe congestion and safety compromises in the Indian railway network. Most of the accidents are due to overcapacity. So, slow expansion is one reason. According to the Standing Committee on Railways, it has noted that slow expansion has led to congestion and safety compromise. An interesting fact you must notice here is that since independence, the railway route kilometers have increased by 23%. So there is a 23% increase in the railway route kilometers. But on the other side, the passengers and the freight traffic has increased by 1,344% and freight traffic by 1,642%. So it is very interesting to see that the total kilometers of the railways has increased by 23% of what was existing since independence. So it is merely 23%, and when it comes to the total number of passengers, it has increased by 1,344%, which is a very big number. And coming to the freight traffic, it has increased by 1,642%. So you can imagine what is the rate of congestion in the Indian railways, and congestion is one major reason for accidents in railway. Another cause of rail accidents in India is natural causes like the flood, landslides, etc. There are also some other causes like vandalism, terrorism, sabotage, etc. So all this causes rail accidents in India. So we have seen what are the causes of rail accidents in India. But there should be some way forward to get rid of this rail accidents. So let us analyze what is the way forward for Indian railways. The first thing which we can do is to optimize the railway timetables. This means that the railway timetables should be revised in order to ensure that the railway staff or the workmen get enough time for safety check every day or on a daily basis. The second measure can be to conduct timely inspection. Field inspections must be done, and this will increase the accountability, which will lead to decrease in the level of rail accidents in India. Another important measure can be to improve the infrastructure of the Indian railways. This will include replacing aging and unsafe carriers with modern coaches. If the rail accidents or the rate of rail accidents has to come down, there must be sufficient investment into the capital as well as the maintenance of the Indian railways. So capital investment must be there. Also, money should be allotted for the maintenance of the Indian railways. This is very, very important. Another measure can be to eliminate unmanned level crossings. For this, the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Indian Railways has suggested two things. The first one is to implement audio-visual signals at level crossings to warn the road users about the approaching trains. So, the first one, audio-visual warnings. And the second suggestion by the committee was that road speed breakers must be constructed before the level crossing gates. Why? In order to regulate the speed of the approaching traffic. So, speed breakers should be constructed. These two were the recommendations of the Parliamentary Standing Committee with regard to the unmanned level crossings. Another measure can be to fill the vacancies in the Indian railways. We have already seen that there is 20% of shortage in the loco pilots and around 16% shortage in safety staff. So if these vacancies are filled in the railways, efficiency of the working staff can be improved, and this will lead to lesser number of accidents. And we have seen that accidents caused due to human error. So this can be eliminated if the number of vacancies are filled in the Indian railways. This will add to the efficiency. At present, around 2 lakh vacancies are there in the Indian railways. And another recommendation was that the railway staff must be given regular refresher courses to make them aware about the accidents, technology upgradation in the railways, etc. So training can be given. Also, already existing staff must be given regular training. Also, an independent safety authority can be appointed. Another thing which could be done is to implement technological innovation. It means new technologies can be adopted from various parts of the globe. Another thing is to shift to LHB coaches. Another important measure to be taken is the optimal utilization of the capacity. Optimal utilization of capacity. This means that the Indian Railways uses around 130 to 150% of the capacity or the maximum capacity on busy routes. It means that there is a proper over-utilization of the capacity by the railways. Optimally, it should be 80 to 90% of the capacity. So, in the busy routes, we have seen an increased use of the capacity. So, this must come down to 80 to 90%. And this is what we have said in congestion. It means over-utilization or congestion. This should come down. The rate of congestion should come down in the Indian Railways. Now let us look into some recent government initiatives in order to cut down the rail accidents in India. Government initiatives. The first one is Mission Zero Accident. Mission Zero Accident. And this was proposed in the Union Budget of 2016-17. Budget 16-17. And the Mission Zero Accident of the government comprises of two sub-components. The first component is the elimination of unmanned level crossing. Eliminating unmanned level crossing. The second one is train collision avoidance system. Train collision avoidance system. The train collision avoidance system aims to prevent train collisions by preventing accidents which are caused due to driver's error or overspeeding of the train. Another government initiative is the Rashtriya Rail Sanraksha Ghosh. Or National Rail Safety Fund. Rashtriya Rail Sanraksha Ghosh or National Rail Safety Fund. This was announced in the budget 2017-18. The corpus of this fund is 1 lakh crore over the next 5 years. That is from 17-18 to another 5 years. And this 1 lakh crore, this fund will be used for track improvement, bridge rehabilitation, improved inspection system, human resource development and safety work at the level crossing. Another government initiative was the GIS and remote sensing. GIS and remote sensing. GIS means geographic information system. So the government of India has signed a memorandum of understanding with ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization, for remote sensing and GIS at unmanned level crossings. So, at unmanned level crossings. This is a right move from the part of the government. And later on, this can be used for natural calamities also. Another initiative from the part of the government was to eliminate the unmanned crossings. Eliminate unmanned crossings. The government aims to eliminate all the unmanned crossings by the year 2020. So by 2020, the aim of the government is to eliminate all the unmanned rail crossings. Another major initiative of the government was regarding the LHB coaches. LHB coaches. The government has decided that henceforth only LHB coaches will be manufactured. So these are the government initiatives. Now let us look at an important committee regarding the rail safety. That is the Anil Kakodar Committee. Anil Kakodkar Committee. This committee was appointed by the government in the year 2012 in order to look into the problems of rail safety in India. And this committee has come up with certain recommendations. Let us see what are the recommendations of this committee. This is a very important committee. You should not by heart all the recommendations, but you should have an idea what were the recommendations given by the committee. So this committee is very important. The first important recommendation of this committee was to implement an independent body like the Railway Safety Authority. So independent body should be appointed. So independent body should be appointed and the committee said that this should have a chairman and also some experts from outside the railways. So chairman and experts. The next recommendation of this committee was to build a robust and powerful safety architecture for the Indian Railways. So, to build a robust and powerful safety architecture. Another recommendation of this committee was to eliminate all the manned as well as unmanned level crossings or the railway level crossings in the country within next 5 years. Eliminate all the level crossings, that is manned as well as unmanned level crossings, within a period of 5 years. The committee also said that the elimination of this level crossings will lead to saving operation and maintenance cost at the railway level crossing gates. So this will save operational and maintenance cost at the level crossing gates. And according to this committee, doing away with the level crossings, that is doing away with manned and unmanned level crossings, will require 50,000 crore. So if we have to do away with level crossings, some similar things should be adopted, like, you know, audiovisual signals must be given or something like that. So this will require 50,000 crores. And this committee says that the elimination of level crossings will lead to saving operational and maintenance cost, which would be annually around 7,000 crore. So for the maintenance of these level crossings, we require 7,000 crore annually. And for the elimination of this, 50,000 crore is needed in order to adopt some technology. And if we look at this saving cost, in 8 years, you can meet the expenditure of the elimination of level crossings. So you can save 7,000 crore every year. That means within 8 years, this 50,000 crore can be recouped. Another recommendation of this committee was better coordination between the railway staff and the police. Coordination between railway and police. This will also lead to decrease in rail accidents. Another recommendation was to adopt advanced signaling system like in European countries. Advanced signaling system. Another recommendation of this committee was to amend the Railways Act in order to impose stringent punishment of people who are found guilty of sabotage. Amendment of Railways Act. Why? To punish those who are found guilty of sabotage. Another recommendation of this committee was to amend the Public Premises Eviction Act. Public Premises Eviction Act. By amending this act, eviction of encroachment can be possible with the help of the local police. So these were, in short, the recommendations of Anil Kakodkar Committee, and this is very important regarding safety of Indian Railways.